single parents off the table. Now there is some constructive denial among us of what that really means. And so my criticism is not of Obama, my criticism of us is the denial of us, of the reality of our political circumstances in this country. So that we can defer our political agency over to somebody who becomes a co-sponsor, over some union that endorses, and think that that's where the muscle is to win. Does it take 2 minutes?
Sure does.
Man, I'm just getting started.
Keep going.
Our work is to bring that political agency back into the community, and to the communities throughout the United States. We have the political capacity to win. What we're lacking is courage and will and confidence to win. These people in office work for us, and we must put their feet to the fire. What has happened to us in the past 40 years to flip the switch such that we are like happy to be in the room with John Cottis? I don't care. You know, I want to talk for just one more minute. John Conyers invited six single-parent activists into his office during the time Barack Obama was running for president. And he said, Barack Obama is my friend. He supports single-parent, he told me. This was John Conyers' strategy to get the single-parent movement to vote for Barack Obama. And let me tell you, that's what their strategy still is. Their strategy is to get this man to win. It's the tribalism of the Democratic Party. They don't care about you. When Kucinich can be flipped, Winnick can be flipped, Sanders can be flipped, Conyers can be flipped, who the hell can we believe in? We must believe in ourselves to build the muscle to compel these people to create the reality that we want and deserve. Too many people are dying out here. Do you know the number of people did not have medical insurance and died because of it in 1992 when the Clinton stuff jumped off? Figure out that number, because that number is less than, and that was a measure of one of the measures of the healthcare crisis in the United States. That number is less than the number of people who will be without insurance when this new shit comes into existence. You know, and then where did we go? Nowhere but backwards. But we have given this industry billions of dollars to continue making money to deny care, but that ain't the end of it. What they did was they are compelling us to buy insurance that we don't need and can't afford under penalty of a civil penalty. What's up with that? That's arguably a constitutional violation that should be litigated, but that'd be litigated forever and we never win. Law is nothing but, and this is for the young people studying, law is nothing but somebody's morality written on paper and enforced by people who have the power to enforce it. Our job is to be in place to create our own morality and our own law to enforce it. So are we going to win?
Yeah.
Are you going to stay independent political activists?
Yeah.
Are you going to be unafraid to go up against people who say, you know, you're responsible for Tuolde versus Tuolde getting elected? Huh? So let's continue to build independent political action and individual political action as a core strategy in the single-parent movement. Without that, we cannot win.
So we were hoping that we would have some good time for questions and discussions, because what we really want to do, the meat of this really is the work we have to do now, is to form that clarity and how we're going to move forward in this movement.
Thank you.